Hello! In this video, let's see how to create an interactive image. Interactive image is a great way to show lots of information while making a visual impact. It's often used in digital magazine, interactive presentation, and digital learning. By clicking on the hotspots, users display additional content, text, image, videos, links. With PandaSuite, you can make it fully custom. How to create an interactive image with PandaSuite? First, let's add the background image. Here, we are using an image, but it can also be a video, a GIF. Make the image full screen using the stretch and alignment options. Now, let's add a button. You can import an existing image or design your own button in PandaSuite Studio. I'm choosing the second option and designing my button using a black circle and white rectangles to make the plus icon. Once it's done and aligned, group all the elements together. Rename it and choose a clear name, let's say button 1. Let's design the popover. First, it will be static. There are several ways to display additional content. Open a full screen pop-up window, add links, or use a popover. I chose the popover because the content is short and I want it to be displayed above the image. Let's add the content by copy-pasting from the external source. Let's create the other buttons and popovers by making copies of this object. Add the content inside. Now we've got a good overview of what it will look like when all the popovers are open at the same time. Let's see how to hide or display the popover. For each popover, let's use the multi-state component and create two states. In the first state, the popover will be hidden, and in the second state, it will be displayed. To add a multi-state component, you can either go to the component list, add a multi-state component, copy-paste the popover inside, realign. Or you can automatically convert the selection into multi-state using the layout menu. Rename this multi-state component and click on the object list to go inside and edit its content. In the first state, let's hide the popover. Select all the objects and change opacity to 0. Create a new link state and in this state, rechange opacity to display everything. Go back to the screen level. Select the button and add an action, single tap click, interact with the component. Select the multi-state and choose next state. By enabling the loop mode, the button will go to one state to the other and hide and display the popover indefinitely. Now, let's do the same with the other messages. In this example, the buttons can be opened at the same time. If you want to automatically close the popover when opening the new one, you need to add a condition. To grab users' attention, you can also make the button animated. In this case, you'll simply need to convert the button into a multi-state component. Change its size in the state and automatically go from one state to the other to create this bouncing effect. Now it's your turn to create an interactive image. Go to our YouTube channel to watch other video tutorials.